Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now since the last video I've cleaned up a lot of the monsters in the hall 4, especially the Liliths, which as you can see gave me quite a bit of gold. So before we head out to level 5 I figured it was about time we upgraded some of our equipment. Now it's a little bit of a toss-up whether you want to upgrade your armor, which is obviously going to increase your survivability a bit, or your weapons and magic. But because we've been falling behind in weapons and magic a little bit, I felt like those are probably the things to upgrade next. Our armor is already one level below the maximum which we could have right now, so I think that's good enough for the moment. So before we start upgrading everything, as always, if we're going to use a lot of cash, we want to equip our bottle first to get our charisma bonus. Let's see, yeah, if I time this right, I think we can get all of the stuff we want with just a single bottle, which is another advantage of this hidden shopping area. Everything is so close together that even if your wisdom is low, you can still upgrade everything pretty quickly, and usually using only one bottle. So first, we want to upgrade our weapon. So use the bottle, immediately enter the store, and get the halberd for the discount price. Yes. So now our melee weapon is pretty much maxed out until we can find any magic weapons, which we'll find in the lower levels. Okay, so we'll exit here and then immediately go into the magic shop. Now I could of course buy a higher level dex spell, but sometimes you really want to be able to hit a single monster at a time, just so you can take out most of the monsters and leave the rest alive to kill with your melee weapon. So I think in this case we will get, no, not the deck poison, the tilt. Tilt is the second strongest single target spell. Let me show you real quick, death is way out of our league for the moment, we won't be able to afford that for quite some time. But tilt will get rid of almost any creature pretty quickly, so that's definitely going to be good enough for now. Now we have about 4,500 gold left. We can't really do anything significant with that amount of gold, but what we can do, no, exit, is spend it on keys again. Just to get us back up to 50, or well, close to 50. Now first things first, let's equip our weapons. Equip our magic. Equip magic. Equip magic. There we go. We can sell off our old weapon. Oh, by the way, our strength is falling a little bit because we were so extremely experienced with the battle axe. The battle axe actually outdamaged our halberd, which is pretty crazy considering they're so far apart on the list. Battle axe is F, halberd is J, so even a low level weapon with a lot of experience can way outdamage the higher level weapons. But for now we'll just sell it, because we don't need it anymore. We will also sell our needle spell, because we don't need that anymore. Not a great deal of gold from that, but that's okay. We'll keep our deck mitar for now, because occasionally it's going to be useful to have a deck spell as well. So with that done, we will head back to the king. And the reason I'm going back to the king is because I want to upgrade my magic resistance. And of course we can upgrade our magic resistance a little bit by going to the temple, but I want to focus on it for a little while. And to focus on a single statistic, you have to visit the king. So that is what we'll do. Go all the way back up top. It's a little bit out of our way, but not too much, thanks to the shortcut. Let me just... So again, our equipment has gotten a pretty big upgrade since the previous stuff. Especially our magic is finally up to what we should be at this level. It might even actually be a little bit overpowered for level 5, but it doesn't hurt to be a little bit overpowered. Okay, we got another fighter level, another wizard level, and that's it. So three more levels, giving us 6 statistics points in total. We've already upgraded our strength quite a bit in the meantime, so we don't really need any more of that. Ideally, we could use a little bit of extra experience. But in this case, I'm really going to want to focus on magic resistance because we've fallen behind quite a bit in that specific statistic. Now let me see. I think I just want to spend most of it. Well, let's get it up to a clean 50. It's still not going to be very good magic resistance, but it's getting there. I have one left. Do I want agility? You know what? I think we want a little bit extra dexterity as well, because the boxes were getting a little bit annoying to open. So I'm just going to waste 1 point on dexterity. It's not a statistic you really need, but it's going to be convenient, so... I tend not to play these games for the absolutely optimal way of playing, just because it's a bit of a headache. The item shop... I still don't think we need to buy anything. Did I ever show you the inside of this one? You can buy all the items that you can find in the dungeon below, but... because you find so many of them, of the monsters, and just in towers and stuff like that, I almost never come here to buy stuff. And I also don't usually sell my stuff, because any item you sell is only worth 50 gold, so even the really strong items, like winged boots, which are very expensive to buy, if you sell them, only give you 50 gold, so it's not really worth it. Okay, we've got everything upgraded, so we'll go back to the dungeon. And I think we're gonna just head straight for level 5, even though there's still a bunch of creatures running around level 4 that we could kill. Most of them aren't really worth it. I might go back there later to pick up... I think there's probably still one or two elixirs in level 4. I might go back for those later, but for the moment, we're good. Now let me just equip something else before I use my last bottle accidentally. Level 4 also didn't have an end boss, so that's another reason not to waste too much time there. The end bosses, if they're there, you really want to try and take them out as quickly as possible, because they almost always hide something good. If it's not a crown, which of course you need to get to the next to the end of the game, then at least it's going to be strength upgrades, sometimes intelligence upgrades or other ones. So yeah, if there's a boss monster around, you really want to take it out. Actually, you know what, let's just find one more critter to kill here, just to try out our new equipment. So cockatrice, oops. Already our magic resistance is making a big difference. Those cockatrices were doing about 1500 or so damage with their spells, and now it's only about 5, so... yeah, definitely worth the investment. And the tilt, as you can see, 11,000, and it's not even, we haven't even gained any experience with it yet, so clearly a very strong magic spell. Now our halberd is going to be a slightly different story. It's slightly worse than the axe was, but that's just because our axe was extremely powered up. We had 255 maxed out experience with it, so yeah. As our halberd grows in experience, oops, I let him hit me from the side, that's why the damage was so high on that one. As our halberd levels up, it's going to be much, much better than our axe ever was. So nice to have the quick opening boxes again. Shriekers. Might have actually been better off using the dex spell for these guys. That's the main reason you want dex spells, is monsters that have very strong magic attacks that just hit you automatically. Of course, this is only a needle, so these guys are pretty harmless for me right now. Thanks to our increased magic resistance, they do very, very little damage. Although we are running kinda low on hit points, so maybe we have to be a little bit careful. Especially if we head down to level 5, I am going to probably have to try to collect enough gold to get a healing. And actually, maybe it would be wise to do that here before we move on to level 5. I think we need quite a lot of gold now for healing. Well, it's a lot, but could have been worse. We can probably piece together 6,500 gold in this level. Yeah, with these guys, for example. But I am going to use my mitre to get rid of these guys. Hornets don't usually drop anything useful, and they have a very strong melee attack, so I don't want to fight those with my melee weapon. But actually, we are already coming back up on the time again. Wow, these videos go by so quickly. okay guys, well, I'll cut it off here. I'll collect enough gold to get a heal going, and then I'll meet you back in the next level. Okay guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you there.